हेलो एवरीवन, सो दिस इज़ हेमंत पांडे अगेन. आई एम द सीनियर लेक्चरर. आई एम फ्रॉम इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड टेलीकम्युनिकेशन. एंड सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ बेस बायपोलर जंक्शन ट्रांजिस्टर. सो बेसिकली इट इज़ अ चैप्टर नंबर 6, बट हियर दिस इज़ आवर चैप्टर नंबर 5. मीन्स फ्रॉम द सीक्वेंस 5 इट इज़ 5, बट द नंबर ऑफ दैट चैप्टर इज़ अ चैप्टर नंबर 6. ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द बायपोलर जंक्शन ट्रांजिस्टर. Fine. So let us see what do you mean by bipolar. Okay, so in the earlier lectures we have seen that the function of diode, right? So di means two, ode means electrode. So diode has a two electrode, right? Now here bipolar, right? Bipolar, polarity means plus or minus, right? So here we have two junctions, bipolar junctions. So here we have two junctions. Let us see which type of junction we have. It is a transistor which consists of two junction, right? Bipolar junction. So let us see how it goes. It is a three layer device with two PN junction, right? So here you can see two PN junction. So as I told you earlier, bipolar junction. Okay, so it has bi means two. It will have a two junction. Okay, so in diode there was only one PN junction, right? So since there was only one PN junction, we have only two electrode, two terminals. One was anode and second one was cathode. But here what will happen? Since there are two PN junction, we will have a three terminals. Okay, so the first one is a collector, second is a base, and third one is a emitter, right? Now depend on the places of that P-type and N-type semiconductor, it is divided into two types. The first one is NPN transistor, okay, and the second one is PNP transistor. So in NPN transistor, first there will be a N-type semiconductor, then P-type semiconductor will be in middle, and after P-type again we have a N-type semiconductor. And in second one, vice versa, right? That is, first one is a p-type semiconductor, in the middle we have n-type semiconductor, and after that again we have a p-type semiconductor. So in both these type of semiconductor we will have a two p-n junction. Let us see here. Okay, before that let us see what are the symbols of the BJT. So if someone asks you what are the types of BJT, we can say that it is a npn transistor and pnp transistor, right? And you can see here the symbol, right? So this symbol shows that the upper one is a collector, then the second one is a base, and the last one is the emitter. Okay, so in the both the symbol there is only one difference. You will see that in NPN transistor the arrow, right, the arrow from in the emitter terminal is towards the downwards, okay, and in the PNP it is towards the upward. So what does that mean of that arrow? Okay, so here basically arrow represents the direction of the convectional current. Okay, in general let us understood direction of the current, that's it. Okay, so this arrow indicates the direction of current. So in NPN transistor it is going towards, and in PNP transistor it is going towards the base. Okay, in NPN transistor it is going towards the emitter, but in PNP it is going towards the base. So these are the two types of symbol of the BJT transformer, BJT transistor. Okay, so here you will understood how is the construction of PNP and NPN transistor is. Okay, so you can see the green region is nothing but a P-type region, right? And the left hand side of the P-type semiconductor, we can see there is a one terminal which is emitter. Okay, hence that region is known as emitter region. Then the second one is N-type, right? Since it is a PNP, so second one will be N-type semiconductor, which is in a blue color, sky blue, right? So it is a base region. Why? Because base terminal is coming from that region. And the last one is collector region, right? It is again P-type semiconductor. So you can see the two junction, right? One junction is between green and blue, and the second junction is between blue and again green, right? That is base collector junction and emitter base junction. So you can see in the arrow here, you can see this, right? Emitter base junction, and it's a collector base junction, right? And these are the three terminals, emitter, base and collector, right? In the diode, we have only two terminals. One was anode and second one was cathode. But in PNP transistor or in NPN transistor, we have three terminals, emitter, base and collector. Okay, and we have two junction. One is emitter base junction and second one is collector base junction. Let us see what is the difference next type. Right, okay. So again, in NPN transistor, you will see that the construction is exactly same, right? The only difference is N-type is replaced by P-type and P-type is replaced by N-type. That is the only difference, right? So here you can see again, first one is N-type, then P-type is again sandwiched between the two N-type semiconductor, and emitter base junction, collector base junction is same like earlier. So, and there are three terminals again, emitter, base and collector, right? So the left one is emitter, center one is base and the last one is a collector. That is the right one, right? So construction of NPN and PNP transistor are exactly same, right? Only the place of the semiconductor, right, is different. Okay, so let us see what are the different significance of these things. So let us read one by one. The NPN transistor is formed by sandwiching P-type semiconductor between two N-type semiconductor. Okay, so here we are studying only one type, construction of only one type, that is NPN, because in PNP and NPN are exactly same. So there is no need to read again for PNP, right? So if we want to write for the PNP, what we will write? The PNP transistor is formed by sandwiching N-type semiconductor between two P-type, right? But since here is it is a NPN, so there will be two N-type semiconductor and one P-type semiconductor. So that is why it is written here. The NPN transistor is formed by sandwiching P-type semiconductor between two N-type semiconductor, right? Okay. So in both the type, you can see base is in between the collector and emitter region, right? So here you can see this. In both this transistor, whether it is a PNP or it is a NPN, we can see that base is always in the middle of the two semiconductors, right? Okay. So that is the point number two. In both type, base is in between the collector and emitter region, okay? Now base is very thin and lightly doped region, right? So what do you mean by dope? All right, so in the chapter number in the earlier chapter, diode and its application, right, we have come through one definition which was doping, right? So what is the definition? What is doping means? The process of adding impurities to pure semiconductor, right? So that process is known as doping. So if here it is written that emitter and collector are much more doped than base, that means emitter, that is emitter and collector semiconductor, these two semiconductor are much doped than the middle one, right? So if it is much more doped, it means we have a more number of majority carriers, right? Because if it is a P-type semiconductor, we will have a more holes, right? But here it is a NPN transistor, right? So NPN means emitter and collector, right? You can see here in NPN, emitter and collector, both are made up of N-type semiconductors. So it means we have a more number of free electrons in emitter and collector region, right? So in this emitter region and in collector region, we will have a more number of free electrons. Why? Because it is heavily doped. And in base region, it is not heavily doped, right? It is lightly doped. So since it is a lightly doped, we have only a few number of holes available, right? Are you getting it? So if you are not getting it, just go to the chapter number 4th, that is diodes and its application. There you will, it is a chapter number 5th. So there you will understood what I'm talking about. Okay, what do you mean by doped and everything? So what does it written? Emitter and collector are much more doped than base. So from this line, we can conclude that in both the N-type, we have a more number of free electrons. But in P-type, we have a very less number of holes, right? Okay. And the last point is, emitter is the most heavily doped and collector area is slightly larger than the emitter, right? So what does it mean? That is, the most heavily doped is emitter, right? Here it is written, emitter is the most heavily doped. And second heavily doped will be a collector, and of course last one will be definitely a base. So if we are talking about doping, first is emitter, then collector, and then the base. But here we have to understood that emitter is lightly heavily doped than collector, right? Means there is not much difference between the doping between the emitter and collector, and same goes for area, right? Collector area is more than emitter, but there is a very slight difference. Okay, so if we talking about area, first one will be the collector, and second one will be the emitter, and the last one will be the base. Okay, so this is the construction of NPN transistor. In PNP transistor, it is exactly same. The only difference is the first line, right? In the first line, what we have to write, we have to replace P by N and N by P. That's it. Rest of all the points will remain same in the construction of PNP transistor. Nothing change. Okay. So this is the construction of NPN transistor. So let's stop here. Okay. In the next video lecture, we will start further. Thank you.